In this video, I'm going to finish the adding and subtracting radical expressions worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now, picking up where we left off with number 21, I need to simplify the radicals, finding that greatest perfect square. So simplifying the square root of 20 and the square root of 8. 20 I can write as 4 times 5, where that greatest perfect square is 4, so that's 2 squared times 5. And then 8, I can write as 4 times 2, which is 2 squared times 2. So I'll have negative 3 times the square root of 2, plus 3 times the square root of 2 squared times 5. And then I'll subtract 3 times the square root of 2 squared times 2. I'll pull out my bases where my exponents are 2 within those radicals. So I'll have negative 3 times the square root of 2, plus 3 times 2 times the square root of 5, pulling out that 2, and then 3 times 2 times the square root of 2, again pulling out a 2. So I'll have negative 3 times the square root of 2, plus 3 times 2, which is 6, times the square root of 5, minus 3 times 2, which is 6, times the square root of 2. Now I have two terms where the numbers are multiplied by the square root of 2. That's negative 3 times the square root of 2, and 6 times the square root of 2, so I'll combine those similar terms. Negative 3 times the square root of 2 minus 6 times the square root of 2 is going to be negative 9 times the square root of 2, and I'm still adding 6 times the square root of 5. That's my simplified expression in number 21. Let's continue on to number 22. In number 22, I'll start by simplifying the square root of 8. So I'll have 8 equal to 2 times 4, which is 2 times 2 squared, where 4 is the largest perfect square that's a multiple of 8. At the same time, I'll combine negative 3 times the square root of 3 and then subtract 3 times the square root of 3 from that, since both have a value of 3 within that radical. Negative 3 times the square root of 3 minus 3 times the square root of 3 is negative 6 times the square root of 3, and then I'll subtract the square root of 8, which I'll write as 2 times 2 squared. Now, I'll pull out a 2 to get negative 6 times the square root of 3 minus 2 times the square root of 2. In number 23, I need to simplify 20 and 18. So 20, I'll write as 4 times 5, which will be 2 squared times 5, and 18, I'll write as 9 times 2, which is 3 squared times 2. Where 4 is the largest perfect square in 20, and 9 is the largest perfect square in 18. So I'll have negative 2 times the square root of 2 squared times 5, and then I'll add 2 times the square root of 18, which is 3 squared times 2, and then I'll subtract 2 times the square root of 5. Pulling out 2 and 3 from my radicals, I'll have negative 2 times 2 times the square root of 5, plus 2 times 3 times the square root of 2, minus 2 times the square root of 5. Negative 2 times 2 will be negative 4, and I'll multiply that by the square root of 5. I'll add that to 2 times 3, which is 6, times the square root of 2, and then I'll subtract 2 times the square root of 5. Now, I'll combine negative 4 times the square root of 5 and take away 2 times the square root of 5. Negative 4 minus 2 will be negative 6, and that will be multiplied to the square root of 5, and then I'll be adding 6 times the square root of 2. And that's my solution in number 23. Now in number 24, I'll actually start by combining 2 times the square root of 18 and 2 times the square root of 18, because I can add those because they have the same value within the radical. So 2 plus 2 is 4, so I'll have 4 times the square root of 18 minus 2 times the square root of 12. Now I'm going to simplify both the 18 and the 12 to find that greatest perfect square. 18 is 2 times 9, which is 2 times 3 squared, and 12 is 3 times 4, which is 3 times 2 squared. So I'll have 4 times the square root of 2 times 3 squared minus 2 times the square root of 3 times 2 squared. So my first radical I'll be pulling out a 3, and my second I'll be pulling out a 2. So I'll have 4 times 3 times the square root of 2 minus 2 times 2 times the square root of 3. 4 times 3 is 12 times the square root of 2 minus 2 times 2, which is 4 times the square root of 3. 12 times the square root of 2 minus 4 times the square root of 3. And number 25, I'll need to simplify the square root of 45 and the square root of 20, finding the largest perfect square. 45 is 9 times 5, which is 3 squared times 5, where 9 is the largest perfect square. 20 is 4 times 5, which is 2 squared times 5, because 4 is the largest perfect square. So I'll have the opposite, or negative, square root of 45, which I'll write as 3 squared times 5, plus 2 times the square root of 5, minus the square root of 20, which I'll write as the square root of 2 squared times 5, and I'm still subtracting 2 times the square root of 6. So now I'll pull out my bases where my exponents are 2. So that's 3 in the first radical, and then 2 in that third radical within the expression. So I'll have negative 3 times the square root of 5, plus 2 times the square root of 5, minus 2 times the square root of 5, minus 2 times the square root of 6. So I'll be combining negative 3 times the square root of 5, 2 times the square root of 5, and 2 times the square root of 5, because they have a value of 5 within the radical. So negative 3 plus 2 is negative 1, and if I'm subtracting 2 from that, that'll be negative 3 times the square root of 5, and I'm subtracting 2 times the square root of 6. That's my solution in number 25. Continuing on to number 26, I'm going to combine each of my terms that have a square root of 20 at the start. So 2 times the square root of 20 minus 1 times the square root of 20 will be 1 times the square root of 20, and then I'm adding 3 times the square root of 20, so 1 plus 3 will be 4 times the square root of 20, and then I'll subtract 2 times the square root of 45. So now I'm going to simplify the square root of 20 and the square root of 45. 20, with a multiple that's a perfect square, will be 4 times 5, which is 2 squared times 5. 45 written with a multiple that's a perfect square will be 9 times 5, which is 3 squared times 5. So I'll have 4 times the square root of 2 squared times 5 minus 2 times the square root of 3 squared times 5. Pulling out the 2 in the first radical and the 3 in the second radical, I'll have 4 times 2 times the square root of 5 minus 2 times 3 times the square root of 5. 4 times 2 is 8 times the square root of 5 minus 2 times 3, which is 6, and then multiplying that by the square root of 5. Now, I'll be able to combine 8 times the square root of 5 and 6 times the square root of 5. 8 minus 6 is 2, so that's 2 times the square root of 5 as my solution in number 26. In number 27, I'll be able to simplify the square root of 45, the square root of 12, and the square root of 20. The square root of 6 is already in simplest form because there's not a perfect square that goes into 6, or essentially there's not a perfect square that's a multiple of 6. So I'll have negative 3 times the square root of 45, which is 9 times 5, which I'll write as 3 squared times 5. And then we'll add that to 2 times the square root of 12, which is 3 times 4, which we can write as 2 squared times 3. And then we'll add that to 3 times the square root of 6, and then subtract 3 times the square root of 20, which the square root of 20 you can write as 4 times 5, which is 2 squared times 5. So now I'll pull out 3, 2, and 2. So negative 3 times 3 times the square root of 5, plus 2 times 2 times the square root of 3, plus 3 times the square root of 6, minus 3 times 2 times the square root of 5. Negative 3 times 3 is negative 9, and we're multiplying that by the square root of 5. 2 times 2 is 4, and we're multiplying that by the square root of 3. 3 times the square root of 6 is 3 times the square root of 6. And 3 times 2 is 6 times the square root of 5, and that 6 times the square root of 5 is subtracted. Now I'll combine my like terms. Negative 9 times the square root of 5 and 6 times the square root of 5. However, since that 6 is subtracted, negative 9 times the square root of 5 minus 6 times the square root of 5 will be negative 15 times the square root of 5, and then I'll add 4 times the square root of 3 and 3 times the square root of 6, since those cannot be combined or simplified any further. So negative 15 times the square root of 5 plus 4 times the square root of 3 plus 3 times the square root of 6 is my solution in number 27. Now, lastly in this video, I'll go over number 28. If you haven't done so before this problem, please click that subscribe button and give me a thumbs up. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated, and just let me know that you're finding these videos useful. Another way to show your support is to share this video with your classmates, so go ahead and do that as well. Now for number 28, I'm going to simplify by combining at the start. I'm going to combine 3 times the square root of 45 and 2 times the square root of 45. However, since this 3 is subtracted, it's like a negative 3. So I'll have negative square root of 27, and then I'll be subtracting negative 3 plus 2 is a negative 1. So subtracting 1 times the square root of 45, which is simply subtracting the square root of 45. And then I'll subtract the square root of 20. And the square root of 45 was subtracted because negative 3 plus 2 is a negative 1. And adding a negative 1 is the same as subtracting 1. And we're multiplying that by the square root of 45. So now I'll simplify each of my radicals. The square root of 27, so I'll have negative square root of 27, I'll write as 9 times 3, which is 3 squared times 3. And then I'll subtract the square root of 45, which I'll write as 9 times 5, which is 3 squared times 5. And then I'll be subtracting the square root of 20, which is 4 times 5, which can be written as 2 squared times 5. So pulling out each of my terms with an exponent of 2, that's pulling out 3, 3, and then 2. So I'll have the opposite of 3, or negative 3, times the square root of 3, minus 3 times the square root of 5, minus 2 times the square root of 5. So I'll be able to combine 3 times the square root of 5 and 2 times the square root of 5. So I'll have negative 3 times the square root of 3 minus negative 3 minus 2 is negative 5. So I'll be subtracting 5 times the square root of 5. So my final solution on this worksheet is negative 3 times the square root of 3 minus 5 times the square root of 5. Again, if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And, as always, like, subscribe, and share.